Good morning, Mrs. Cedars.
I'm Miss Hopewell.
Oh, I saw it said the Cedars on the mailbox back there a piece, so I thought you was Mrs. Cedars.
I've come to speak of serious business.
Well?
Miss Hopewell, I know you believe in Christian service. I know you're a good person.
What are you selling?
Bible. I bet the one like you got is a Bible in your parlor.
I don't care to have a Bible in my parlor.
Lady, the Word of God ought to be in the parlor.
That is a matter of taste.
For a Christian, the Word of God ought to be in every room in the house besides in your heart. I know you're a Christian because I can see it in every line in your face.
But I don't want to buy one, so you just get on out of here.
Miss, I'll tell you the truth. Not many people want to buy one nowadays, and it's a pity. You see, I'm real simple. I don't know how to say a thing, but just to say it, I'm just a country boy. I guess people like you don't like to fool with country people like me.
My mother is always telling me that good country people are the salt of the earth.
Well, you said a mouthful. I didn't introduce myself. I'm Manly Pointed from around Willoughby. Not even from a place, just from their place.
You might as well put that back, because I'm not going to buy one.
I appreciate your honesty. There are very few honest people unless you go way out in the country. I guess a lot of boys come telling you they're working their way through college. But I'm not going to tell you that. Somehow I don't want to go to college. I want to devote my life to Christian service. I got this heart condition. I may not live long. When you know something's wrong with you, ma'am, and that you may not live long.
But I have a condition, too, that I've had in my schooling. I have a Ph.D. in philosophy. My mother thinks that's rather peculiar, but I don't expect her to understand me.
My mother worked hard after my pop got crushed under a tree when I was 8. Mom sent me to Sunday school, made me read the Bible every evening. I've been selling them for about 4 months, ever since my 22nd birthday. I've become a missionary, because that is the one way you can do most for people. He who loses his life shall find it.
Yes.
Listen, did you ever eat a chicken that was 2 days old?
Yes.
Well, it must have been mighty small. Ah! How old are you?
21.
I see you got a wooden leg. I think you're real brave. I think you're real sweet. Tell me, what's your first name?
Helga.
You're shy, aren't you, Helga? Well, I am, too. I ain't one like these people that a serious thought never enters their heads. Because I may die.
I may die, too.
Listen, don't you think some people was meant to meet on account of all they got in common and all? Like, they both think serious thoughts and all? I don't work on Saturday. I like to go walking in the woods, see what Mother Nature's wearing, or the hills and far away. Could we go walking tomorrow? Maybe have a picnic?
Oh, I don't think I'd want to.
Say yes, Helga.
No, I couldn't possibly.
I knew you'd be here.
Why'd you bring your Bible?
Well, you can't never tell when you need the Word of God, Olga.
I don't believe in God.
No. That's pretty unusual for a girl. Where are we going to have our picnic?
Up there.
You can't go up there.
No, I know.
Cover your leg. You said you love me, Nut. You got to say that. Say you love me.
Love is not a word I use.
Well, why not?
All right. If you use the word love loosely, you might say that. But love is not a word I like to use. I don't have any illusions. I'm one of those people that sees through to nothing. Ever since my leg was shot off in that hunting accident,
I find... Say you love me. You got to say it. I said it, now you've got to say it.
Oh, you poor baby. It's just as well you don't understand. We are all damned. But some of us have our blindfolds taken off, and we see that there's nothing to see. It is a kind of salvation.
Okay, but do you love me or don't you?
Well, in a sense, yes. But there's something I must tell you. There mustn't be anything dishonest between us. I am 30 years old. I have a number of degrees.
Listen, I don't care about what all the things you've done. I just want to know, do you love me or don't you?
Yes, I love you. I do.
Okay, then. Prove it. Show me where your wooden leg joints are.
No.
Oh, you just play me for a sucker.
No. No, it joins on at the knee. That's all. Only at the knee. What do you want to know for?
Because it's what makes you so different. You ain't like anybody else. Show me how to put it off and on. See? Now I can do it myself.
Put it back on me now.
Not yet. Let's leave it off for a while. You got me instead.
Put it back on me now.
Wait a minute. Take a swing.
But aren't you good country people?
Yeah, but it ain't held me back none. I'm as good as you any day of the week.
Give me my leg.
What's the matter with you all of a sudden? Just a while ago you said you didn't believe in nothing. I thought you were some girl.
But you're supposed to be a Christian. A fine Christian. But you're just like all the rest of them. You say one thing and do another.
I hope you don't think I believe in all that crap. I may be selling Bibles, but I know which end is up. And I wasn't born yesterday. And I know where I'm going.
Give me my leg!
I've gotten a lot of interesting things. One time I got a woman's glass eye this way. And you needn't think you'll catch me either, because Pointer ain't my actual name. I use a different name in every house I call at, and I don't stay nowhere long. And another thing, Holger, you ain't so smart. I've been believing in nothing ever since I was born.